Tina Elkett, and this is Floof. They're my best friends. I really would do anything for them. I mean, what pet owner wouldn't?
What does my pet mean to me? Oh my God.
And my dog means the world to me. She means everything to me.
She's my most loved creature in the whole world.
When I wake up in the morning, I think about her. When I go to bed, I think about her.
She's one of a kind.
I think she loves me too.
Research shows that 95.5% of dog owners in the U.S. view their pets as part of their family.
And some are even willing to clone them so that they never really lose them.
Hi, my name is Monika. I'm a singer, TV host, author, and animal lover. And this is Jelly, a cloned puppy of Angel.
Monika is one of a select few pet owners that have chosen to clone their beloved fur child in an industry that many have never heard of before. Pet cloning.
I had no idea that cloning was actually a reality. I thought it was like some far-fetched dream. Seeing Angel's cloned puppy is truly amazing.
It's been more than two decades since jaws dropped around the world when Dolly the sheep was born, the first ever mammal cloned from an adult cell.
But since then, tons of companies have popped up around the world, offering pet owners the chance to create genetic replicas of their animal children. Manika chose to get her dog Angel cloned at Biogen, one of the leading agencies in the United States.
We clone dogs and cats and horses too. Dog cloning is $50,000 and cat cloning is $35,000.
That's a whole lot of cash, which is why the clients who clone their pets typically come from wealthier backgrounds.
Hollywood star Barbara Streisand cloned her beloved dog Samantha with Biogen, along with the former First Lady of Iceland, Dorit Musaif, an Israeli jewelry designer who cloned her unique sheepdog, Samur.
So how does the cloning process even work?
So to clone a pet, we're going to need a DNA source from that pet, and that comes from a skin biopsy.
Skin biopsies are typically taken from live pets, but can even be sourced from deceased pets up to 5 days after they've passed away, if their bodies are properly stored. Scientists then culture cells from the tissue to ultimately implant into unfertilized eggs coming from another animal.
Then we will make cloned embryos and transfer them into a surrogate mother. And just like IVF in humans, that embryo transfer may be successful with the first round of transfers. It may not be successful. So if we don't produce a puppy or kitten with the first round of embryo transfers, we will go back and transfer more embryos into a different surrogate. And we'll continue to do that until we have a successful birth.
The average dog lives between 7 to 15 years. So when you look at it that way, paying $50,000 to save you the horrific pain of losing a loved one may sound kind of reasonable. But many animal advocates and ethicists raise strong objections to pet cloning because they believe it creates an industry of farm dogs, since the cloning process often requires numerous dogs to produce a single clone.
To put this into perspective, more than 1,000 embryos were implanted into 123 surrogates to produce the world's first cloned puppy in 2005. Biogen claims the success rate has gone up significantly since then and that their surrogates are treated with the utmost respect.
Without a happy, healthy surrogate mom, the success rates aren't going to be what we want them to be.
Well, even if you don't care about the ethics of cloning, the question is, are you truly getting an exact replica of your beloved pet when you clone it?
The best way to think about a cloned animal is it is simply an identical twin that's born at a different time. So you think about human identical twins, they're going to look very, very similar, but their personality may be different. And so I think the healthy way to think about what a cloned animal is it's a little piece of that original animal.
I have noticed a bunch of behaviors that are very similar from Jelly to what Angel used to do, including when she wants attention, she jumps off on her back two paws, and that she just loves attention, just like Angel did.
So Benji is my clone cat. He's a Bengal cat. And he's still pretty young, but I would absolutely clone him again. He's a wonderful cat. And we've had clients that have cloned their clone.
You know how they say no one's ever really gone, that they live on in your memories and the love you have for them? Well, with Angel, that's definitely true. I see her right here. She's living, she's breathing, and her legacy lives on.
Isn't that right, little Jelly?